results using co-deposition to measure excess heat.
I first met Stan Spock many years ago. We were both working in Navy Laboratory in Corona, California, that's near San Bernardino. Quite a long time ago, that was 1968. What I'm going to show here is I was in Japan with NAT working on with the Weissman Pons powder empty I discussed yesterday. And we did three experiments using co-deposition in the Weissman Pons Luder type cell. And Martin Weissman analyzed this data in this is excess heat, this is time. Right at the beginning, we get a little bit of excess heat, or excess power, if you want to call it that. And then as we increase the current and so on, it went up higher. Because of a long weekend, the laboratory turned the current down over the weekend, and the power, and the excess power went down. And the following Monday, we increased the current more and more, and we got excess power up in this level with the co-deposition method. And actually, we were running three different cells. Weissman only analyzed one cell. I analyzed all three cells with my Coxman method, and I get about the same result. I use a simpler method of analysis. Early excess power, more here. We turned it off during the weekend. This is not really a true. We just drew a line between one of the last measurement and the first measurement the next week. Of course, it went down and more levels off. Then the next Monday, we raised the current. The thing I want to show this one for is these are three different cells. We're running three cells now, and it shows you can show that all three cells are given about the same. These two cells are almost identical. One cell was a little bit less, but this is very reproducible effect that we saw in Japan. All three cells showed the effect, showed it about the same pattern in the same amount of excess heat. An important way to tell when you got excess heat is just look at the temperature. Red line is the temperature, and we apply heating coats, the temperature goes up. This is the baseline. The temperature does not come down to the same baseline. This is another example of positive feedback. When you change the system, heat it up, the effect increases. In fact, this is Martin's analysis. You see that these black dots show that the excess power was increased during this heating coats. This is an example of the heating coats where this does not happen. It doesn't happen every time. We apply the heating coats, the temperature goes up, but it comes back down to the same baseline. So in this case, the excess power was either not there or it remained constant. Actually, it remained fairly constant, as shown by Martin's analysis right here. So this is always a simple way to tell whether you got excess heat without doing the mathematics. Just apply heating coats, see if it comes back to the same baseline. It's a very, very simple method. It doesn't tell you how much, but it tells you whether you have positive feedback. And that's then my talk. Thank you.